Let's work through the following problem together. A ball is thrown vertically upward from the ground with a velocity of 20 meters per second. Find the time when the object reaches its highest point. What is this height? Assume acceleration is due solely to gravity, which is negative 9.8 meters per second squared. Okay, so this is a problem about the motion of a ball, right, that's thrown upward. So here we're relating acceleration, velocity, and position. We're given information about the acceleration, right? We know what the acceleration is. Ultimately, we'd like to know information about the position of the ball. We want to know what is the highest point. What is this height, the highest height that the ball achieves? So if you recall the relationship between position, velocity, and acceleration, velocity is the derivative of the position function, and then acceleration is the derivative of the velocity function. Right, so to get from position to acceleration, for example, we take the derivative twice. But here we want to get from acceleration to position. So we're going to use antiderivatives instead of derivatives. Okay, so let's start by writing down an acceleration function. Okay, well, we're told that acceleration is due solely to gravity, and it's negative 9.8 meters per second squared. So we know then that just acceleration is constant, right? It's always negative 9.8. So from this, I'd like to use antiderivatives to get to the velocity function, so that ultimately I can find the position function. But this in itself isn't quite enough information, right? If I were to take the antiderivative of this, I would get an expression for velocity, but it would have a plus c in it. Okay, so let me just also note here that acceleration is v prime, right, the derivative of velocity. But if I want a specific solution, or what we call a particular solution, then I need an initial condition, okay? And I know that, right? I know that at time equals zero, when the ball is thrown upward, it has a velocity of 20, okay? So that tells me v of zero equals 20. So then knowing v prime of t, or the acceleration, and knowing one specific point on that velocity curve is enough information for me to find a particular velocity function. Okay, so v of t then is going to be the integral of acceleration. Okay, and if I find the antiderivative here, so that's going to be negative 9.8 t, right? The derivative of negative 9.8 t gives me back my negative 9.8, but then I have to add this plus c, okay, because plus any constant would also give me the same derivative. So I have this general solution, what we call a general solution. But I want a particular solution. So that's where my initial condition comes into play. So I know that velocity is 20 at time equals 0. So I just simply plug in that information, and I discover that c must equal 20. So now I know that v of t is negative 9.8 t plus 20. Okay, and this is the particular solution. Okay, so that's good. Now next, so I ultimately want to know its highest point, so I'm going to need to know the position function. So let's do the same thing to find the position function. So I'm going to call the position function height, because it tells us the height of the ball. So the velocity is h prime of t. And we need some point on that height curve. And we know that the ball is thrown vertically upward from the ground. So at time equals zero, the height of the ball is zero. Okay, so now I can actually solve for the height function. Okay, it's the antiderivative of velocity. Okay, so if I solve this, I can split this up if it's helpful. So remember, I can pull constants out front, and I can also split up sums. So this is the same as this. So the antiderivative of t is t squared over 2. And of 20 is 20t. And then I add a plus c. Okay, so if I clean that up a little bit, 9.8 divided by 2 is 4.9. So this is negative 4.9 t squared plus 20t plus C. And once again, this is the general solution, so I want to use my initial condition to find a particular solution. So height is 0 when time is 0. So 0 equals 0 plus 0 plus C, so C equals 0. And my particular solution then is negative 4.9 t squared plus 20 t. That's the height of the ball. This gives the height of the ball at any time t. Okay, so now let's now that we have all our functions, let's try to find the information we're actually asked about. So first of all, it says find the time when the object reaches its highest point, and then we want to know what actually is that height. So let's start with the first question. Find the time when the object reaches its highest point. Okay, so what I'm really doing then is I'm looking for where the maximum height occurs. Okay, and how do I find where a maximum occurs? Okay, so I want to know where does maximum height occur? So remember, anytime we want to find a maximum or minimum of our function, we're going to use information from the derivative to do that. So the derivative of the position function is the velocity function, and we already have that, right? We know that v of t is negative 9.8 t plus 20. So we want to find any critical points of that, right? So if I take, so this is already the derivative. So this is derivative of h of t, and I'm setting it equal to 0 to find critical points. Negative. So I get 9.8 t equals 20. Well, t equals 20 over 9.8, which is approximately 2.041. Let's just make sure that that's a maximum. Let's see, we can use either the first or the second derivative test. Actually, the second derivative test would be pretty easy in this case because we know the second derivative, right? So velocity was first derivative. Second derivative is the acceleration, which we know is negative 9.8. Okay, so that's negative. Okay, and that tells me that my function is always concave down. So my critical point must be a local max. Okay, so local max at approximately 2 seconds. Okay. And that's the only critical point, right? So I know that it's definitely the highest point that the ball achieves happens there. So that's when it occurs. We also want to know what is that height. Okay, so to find what the height of the ball is at that point, I'm going to plug it into the height function. So height at that point. So I'm just plugging it in, so negative 4.9 times 2.041 squared plus 20 times 2.041. If you plug that into your calculator, you should get approximately 20.4 feet. Okay, so we could say something like the ball reaches a maximum height of about 20.4 feet at about 2.041 seconds. And actually, I should say meters, right? It was originally in meters per second, so this should all be meters. Sorry about that. I'm going to be consistent with our units there. So feet, meters. Meters and meters. Okay, so max height of about 20.4 meters at about 2 seconds.